Hello viewers, good morning to all. Welcome to the new session of our e-learning class. I am Rashmi Ranjan Mishra, lecturer of UN Autonomous College of Science and Technology. Today I am going to discuss on a subject regarding entrepreneurship and small business management. So on today's discussion I am going to discuss with you relating to the product life cycle and a marketing mix, how it is made at the time of starting the new ventures by the entrepreneurs. So let us come together, watch my video. If you have any doubt, then you can give your comment in the comment section. So first, product life cycle. A new product progresses through a sequence of stages from introduction to growth, maturity and decline. This is the stages of product. When a product launches into the market, the first one is introduction stage, then after that is growth, then maturity, and the last one is decline. So this is known as product life cycle, and this is associated with various changes in the marketing situation and hence impacting in the marketing strategy and a marketing mix. The product life cycle is an important concept in marketing. So the life cycle, which has four stages, that is introduction, growth, maturity and decline, that we will discuss one by one. So what is introduction stage and how the product is introduced in the primary stage? Once product has been developed, the first stage is introduction. During this stage, the product is being released into the market. And when a new product is released, it is often a high stake time in the life cycle. Although it does not necessarily make or break the product eventually success. So during introduction stage, marketing and promotion at a high speed, and a company invest more relating to the promotion of a product and getting it into the hands of the consumer. As the product is newly to the market and newly for the consumer, for the first time the consumers are using that. So in that case, company spends huge amount of expenditure relating to production, relating to promotion, advertisement, so that the product gets demand in front of the consumer. It is the stage where company is first able to get a sense how consumers respond to the product. If they like it, that's successful. However, it also a heavy spending period for the company with no guarantee. The company having no guarantee that whether the product will pay the amount which has spent at the time of a marketing or not. Costs are generally very high and there is typically little competition. The principal goals of introduction stage are to build demand for the product and get it into the hands of the consumer, hoping that on its growing popularity. Then the second stage, that is growth. So during this stage, consumers are already taking the product. That means product passed from introduction stage and increasing its buying. The product concept is proven and becoming more popular and sales also increase. Other companies, they become aware about that product and its space in the market, which is beginning to draw attention and increasingly pull in revenue. If competition for the product is especially high, companies still have to invest in advertising and promotion for the product to beat the competitors. As a result, the product going and the market itself expands. The product in the growth stage is typically weaker to improve the functions and various features. Then after maturity stage, when product reaches its maturity, sales tends to slow or even stop, signaling large saturated market. And at this point, sales can even start to drop. Pricing at this stage can tend to get competitive, signaling margining or margin shrinking of prices being falling due to the weight of outside pressures like competition or lower demand. Marketing at this point is targeted and a company will have to develop new or alter products to reach to the different market segments. So giving highly saturated market, it is typically the maturity stage of the product that less successful and that are pushed out to the competition, which is often called as a shakeout point. The last stage, that is called as a declining stage. Although companies will generally attempt to keep the product alive in the maturity stage, as long as possible, decline of every product is inevitable. If the declining stage of product sales drop significantly and the consumer behavior changes, there is less demand for the product and the company's product loses more and more market share, and the competition also tends to cause sales to deteriorate. Then next part, that is marketing. How the product is marketing in front of the consumer. Marketing, that is the declining stage, is often minimal and targeted as already loyal customers, and the prices are also reduced. Eventually, the product will be retired out of the market unless it is to redesign itself to remain relevant or in demand. One example, product like typewriter, telegram or muskets, they are deep in their declining stage and in fact are almost or completely retired from the market in today's scenario. Then the next concept, that is pricing. What is that? What are the objectives? What are the various features and a pricing model that we will discuss. Pricing, that means a process to determine what manufacturer receives in exchange of the product. When one manufacturer introduce the product or manufacture that product, then it is ready for sale, and when it sells that to the consumer, in return what the amount received by the manufacturer, that is called as a price. Generally, price depends upon various factors like manufacturing cost, raw material cost, profit margin, etc. There are different objectives. The first one is maximization of a profit in short run. Always the manufacturer or the organization, they wants to increase their profit, and they always wants to maximize the profit in a short period. The second objective is optimization of profit in a long run. Whatever may be the profit, that profit will be optimized, and that is for a long term period. Then maximum return on investment, always wants to get higher rate of return on the invested amount. Then fulfills sales target value, that is another most important objective. Always pricing objectives as fulfill the sales value or the target value. Then obtain target market share, always wants to increase the market potentiality. Then introduction into new market, always they search for introduce in the new market and obtain profit in a whole product line irrespective of individual product profit targets. Then it is also another objective that tackle different competitors or in the competitive market. Then also recover investment very faster. There is stable product price, affordable pricing to the target large number of consumer groups. Then pricing product or service always stimulate economic development. Pricing having certain objectives, that is to price the product so that maximum profit can be extracted. Always pricing having certain objective, or the main objective is to price the product in such a way so that there can be maximum of a profit that to be extracted from that product. What are the various factors that influence pricing? The factors that divided into two parts, that is internal factors as well as external factors. Generally, pricing of a product is influenced by various factors that involves many variables. That factors can be categorized. First one is internal factors. The following are the factors that influence the increase and decrease in the product or price of the product internally. The first one is marketing objectives of the company. What the objectives of the company or marketing objective that is set by the company, based upon that the price fluctuate. If the strategy is not made properly or the target is not made properly and planning is not made, in that case the price also fluctuate. The second one is consumer expectation from company by past pricing. What is the previous experience made by the company from the consumer point of view? That should be taken into consideration. Then product feature, if product having highly features, then it is pricing must be demanded. If the product having no features, in that case the pricing day by day that downsize. Then the next one is position of a product in a product life cycle. The product is in a which stage, whether it is introduction or growth or maturity or decline. Then the rate of product using the pattern of demand, based upon the demand, what is the product rate. Then production and advertisement cost, what is the cost involvement at the time of producing the product as well as advertising the product. Next one is uniqueness of the product. If there is similarity of the product in the market, in that case price must be reasonable, otherwise that cannot be demanded. Then production line composition, what is the line of composition of a production by the company, that should be taken into consideration, and that one factor which fluctuate or influence the price of the product. Then price elasticity as per sales of the product, another internal factors. So these internal factors that influence the pricing that depend upon the cost of manufacturing the product. That includes fixed cost like labor charges, rent, price, and different variable cost like overhead, electricity charges, etc. So the internal factors that we discussed that basically influence the price of the product internally. Then what are the external factors that influence at the time of pricing the product? The following are the various external factors that impacts on increase as well as decrease in the price of the product. The first one is open or closed market, whether the market is in open situation or that is closed down situation. Based upon that, the price will fluctuate. If there is more demand in the product in the market, then price will increase. If there is less demand or there is no marketing of the product, market closed down, then there is the pricing will day by day decreases. Then consumer behavior for given product, whether the consumer accept that product or not. If more and more consumer accept, that is more demand, or the consumer behavior for the product is positive, in that case the price of the product also increases. Then major customer negotiation, how the customer negotiate among themselves to use that product, that is also another external factors influence the price. Then variation in the price of a supply, the prices at the time of a supply, or the product at the time of a supply, what the prices is there. If there is many variation, then that affect. Then market opponent product pricing, what are the other opponents are there, they pricing their products, and what the company usually pricing their product. Then consideration of a social condition, that is also external factor. We have to consider, or the company have to consider, different social condition, and that social condition influence the price of the product. Then price restricted as per the governing authority or by the government. If government fixes the price, then company does not want to increase that. If the company will increase, there will be no demand, the price will be, or there will be huge loss. So these are the several external factors which influence the price, depend upon the elements like competition in market, consumer flexibility to purchase the product, government rules and regulation, etc. are the external factors. Then what is the pricing strategy? Let us now understand the various strategy for pricing. The first one is skimming pricing. That means when a new product is introduced in the market with high price, concentrating on upper segment of the market who are not in price sensitive, and that results is skimmed. Then the second one is penetration. That means if when a product is introduced in the market with a low initial price, that is called as a penetration. The price is kept low only to increase the target consumers, and by using this strategy, more consumers they can be penetrated or they can be reached into. Then another one is discount and allowances. Basically discounts are provided to the consumer or to the customer only to increase the demand of the product in the market. If the company wants to increase its demand for the product in the market or in front of the consumer, then the company must have to provide discount relating to the price of the product, and that will attract the customer to purchase more and more quantity of a product. So at the time of allowing discount or any type of allowances, various points should be taken into consideration. Discount in quantity, if the discount is made, whether it is made in quantity or not. Then discount in trade, what is the volume of a trade, based upon that discount should be made. Discount in cash, whether that is made in terms of a cash discount or in a trade discount. Other type of a discount also made, that takes into consideration the seasonal factors or different types of a promotional discount. Even during the time of off season, the company offer discount on the product to increase the sales, and at the time of a promotional, company also provide various types of discounts relating to the product. So this is discount and allowances. Then the next strategy, that is geographic pricing strategy. The strategy is used to price the product as per geographical location. As the distance increase from the point of production, the cost of production also increases. So when the distance from the particular manufacturing center, it increases, in that case the cost of the product also increases by the company. So for that, the various points should be considered: the point of production pricing strategy, Another one is uniform delivery pricing strategy. The product must be delivered uniformly. Then product also delivered relating to zone wise. So that is called as a zone delivering pricing strategy. Then the next one is freight absorption pricing strategy. That should be taken into consideration based upon the geographical strategy. Then what is marketing concept? Marketing concept means the firm implement only to satisfy the customer needs, increasing sales, maximizing profit, and also beat the competitors. Marketing is one of the department of management which tries to design the strategy that will build profitable relationship. One definition given by American Marketing Association that marketing is the performance of a business activity which direct the flow of goods and services from producer to the consumers. Marketing aims to secure the optimum rate of a movement of a product from factory to the final consumer. What is the basic difference between traditional and modern marketing? The first and foremost difference, that is, traditional marketing is focused on selling the product which are produced by the company. But modern marketing, that first looks the customer satisfaction, that is the basic objectives. Then produce the product according to the needs of the customer or the consumer. And then after selling the product to the targeted customer, that is the most important difference. Then the second, traditional market used medium like flex, board, pamphlets, radio, television. These are the some of the media of advertising. Whereas modern marketing not only uses that traditional medium, but also uses different modern medium or methods like social media marketing, internet marketing, or ad such means which advertised the product in front of the consumer to get more demand of that product. In case of a traditional marketing, research and development is absent. There is no means of research and development of the product in a traditional method of a marketing. However, in case of a modern marketing, it is as a base of research and development of a various product. In case of a modern marketing, the company or the organization, they always use different type of a research and a development capacity to increase the demand for the product or developing that product. Then the next difference, traditional marketing is always product oriented approach, but modern marketing always gives emphasis customer or consumer oriented approach. Then the next one is traditional marketing having profit earning has more weightage, whereas modern marketing is profit motive, that is the secondary satisfaction of the consumer. That means first consumer will be satisfied, then after if consumer will be satisfied, profit automatically come. That is the motto in modern marketing. Profit is the secondary part. The primary part, how the consumer will be benefited or satisfied more and more. But in case of a traditional marketing, the profit is the first and foremost target. Then the second one is, or the next one is, traditional marketing that deals with the circulation of a product irrespective of a satisfaction of a consumer. Whether the consumer is satisfied or not, the basic objective, how to circulate the product in front of the market or towards the market. But modern marketing is not like that. It consider consumer satisfaction, that is the important aspect. So this is the another difference. Then the what is the basic feature of marketing? It is a creative function. It promotes business as well as employment. It coordinates various functions, finance, production, distribution, as well as determine the scale and value of the total product. There is also another emphasis on what the customer wants, then emphasis on social goods, on increasing employment by giving customer the chances to decide. Then the next feature, it is a process of exchange between seller and buyer. It may be a commodity or a service. What is marketing mix? The marketing mix refers to the set of action or a tactics which is used by the company to promote the product. There are four P's of marketing mix: product, price, promotion, and place. But nowadays, marketing mix includes several other P's like packaging, positioning, people, as well as politics. So what is price? Price that refers to the value for a product. It depends upon the cost of production, segment targeted, ability of the market to pay, demand and supply, and a direct and a different other indirect factors. There are several strategies for pricing. Pricing that can be used as a demarcation to differentiate as well as enhance the product. price, then next product. It refers to the item which is actually going to sold. The product must deliver a minimum level of performance, otherwise even the best work on other elements of the marketing mix would not be any good. Then the next one is place. It refers to the point of sale. In every industry, catching the eye to the consumer and making it easy to her to buy the product. Place strategy. The retailers, they must have to pay premium for the right location, and always follow the mantra of successful retail business is location, location, location. That is relating to place. Another one is promotion, which refers to all activities undertaken to make the product or service known to the user. That means the consumer must have to know that the product features, and how the consumer will know for that, the process will be made, that is called as a promotion. This includes various advertising, word of mouth, process reports, incentive, commission, award of the trade. It can also include the consumer scheme, direct marketing contest, and a different prices or prizes. So this is relating to the marketing mix and four P's of a marketing: the features of a marketing, pricing, pricing strategy, features of a pricing, and a different product life cycle or stages of a product life cycle. Hope you students have all cleared about my today's topic. Again, if you have any doubt, then you can give your comment in YouTube comment section. Thank you. Have a good day to all of you.